Hello dear students, welcome. I think in today's class we are going to discuss the whole lessons belongs to encounter book. This encounter books, this come under grade 12 major English, optional English book encounter. It carries 25 marks for our board exam. This book encounter, this book consists of 16 lessons. You know, most of the lessons are belong to history, and rest belong to essays. Especially this book consists of the combination of essays and stories. Now let's start the lesson that come under this book, that is encounter. The first lesson of this book is The Use of Force. The Use of Force is a short story. It was written by Carlos Williams. Especially in the history, that is The Use of Force signifies that one doctor, he is a narrator of the story. He visits Wilson family and he sees that one Wilson child, Mathilda, she is suffering from diphtheria and she has sore throat problem. Doctor wants to diagnose the disease of Mathilda, but Mathilda could not come near to the doctor. So the doctor uses force for benevolent purpose to identify the disease, to diagnose the disease. The doctor has used the force. So the title is really significant here. Especially in this story, there are four characters: the doctor, the narrator of the story, and Mr. Olson's, that is Mathilda's father, Mrs. Olson, Mathilda's mother, Mathilda, one patient, she has throat problem. So here the title, The Use of Force, the doctor, the narrator as a doctor has used this force to identify the disease of the Mathilda. Here the use of force is justifiable and for benevolent purpose. Yet let's say the force is justifiable, but if it is used with good motives in order to save somebody's life, here it becomes unnecessary. Here the basic conflict is between the doctor and the parents of the patients. There are some questions here. The first question is, what is the nature of the conflict in the story? The nature of the conflict is the use of force, that is for ethical and justifiable. And next question is, why does the doctor respect the child but find parents contemptible? Here the use of force shows the conflict between doctor and his patients, one level, and doctor and the parents at another level as well. Here the doctor use of force to identify the disease, to diagnose the disease. So that is all about using force here. Then we have the second lesson is An Episode of War. This is also the short story by Stephen Crane. In the story we see there are some characters, a lieutenant, one main character of the story, and corporal and officers, brigade. These are the characters in this story, An Episode of War. In this story, it shows the inhuman picture of the war. Here the story shows bitter experience of the wounded lieutenant at the war in front of the barracks hospital. Here Stephen Crane has not given a name to the lieutenant, that used the generic name in order to show that war is a bitter experience, not for the individual, not only for all the soldiers of any nationality, place and time. Here one lieutenant was wounded. He was shot while he was distributing coffee in the barracks. When he was shot, his arms was bleeding there. After he became wounded, nobody took care of him, especially when he was taken to hospital. While he was moving from the barracks, no one showed a high sympathy towards him. When he was in the hospital as well, his arms was amputated. With single hand, he went to his house. He became very sad. The overall picture of this study shows the effect, bitter reality of war, bitter reality of war, not only in the barracks but out of it as well. It shows this An Episode of War. It is a very interesting history about lieutenant, the central character, and other character, that is soldiers, corporal. These are also the other character in this history. This also shows a gap between appearance and reality. War is glorified, but soldiers are treated indifferently. A brave war hero is misbehaved wherever he goes. The owner said the lieutenant, apart from his fellow soldier, becomes disillusioned by the war. with his fellow soldier of glory who are here. So there is one question: what are the implications of Crane's comparison of the actual battle to an historical painting? So in the history, the lieutenant sees that a journal is presented a paper by an assistant. So it shows a painting, shows beautiful picture of the war, but in reality it writes the brutality of war. So we see that. Then after another we have very comic story, that is Dajar. Dajar is by Luigi Pirandello, one famous playwright, novelist and short story writer. Especially in the Dajar, two central characters are there. One is Lolo Jirafa, another one is Jidima. Lolo Jirafa, he was a farmer at Prime Soul, and Jidima, he invented miraculous cement, who was a very proud person. The study shows these two characters, we have here, Lolo Jirafa and Jidima. Here we see Lolo Jirafa. Lolo Jirafa, he was a farmer at Prime Soul. In one year, there was a olive crop was very high, and he thought that the 5 old jars would not be sufficient to hold all the well of their harvest. So he planned to make a new jar. When he made a new jar and he set in the cow shed, in the shed there, later on he found that the jar were broken. Then he called a person, Jidima, in order to repair it. Jidima repaired it by sitting inside the jar. So when he completed that, he could not come out from the jar. He trapped inside the jar there. Later on, Lolo, he asked Jidima to break the jar. If he broke the jar, then he should pay fine of the jar. So then he stayed out inside the jar and settled there. So Jidima and his friend, they shouted and they danced. Jidima dance inside the jar and other dancing outside there. By the noise of their sound, Lolo Jirafa, he woke up at house. He saw that very, very whimsical activities. Then he could not control himself and he ran like a mad bull and he hit the jar and the jar broke into two pieces. In this way, Jidima came out of from the jar. And this story shows the comic plight of two characters, Lolo Jirafa and Jidima. Then we have some question here. How would you describe the interplay between the history of Jidima and that of Lolo? What is the meaning of that is defined by this interplay? Especially the interplay between two main characters, Lolo Jirafa and Jidima, really interesting one. These two characters have very comic role in this story. This story is really full of comedy mode. It shows Lolo Jirafa and Jidima. That is really ridiculous matter is there. And Lolo Jirafa, he is very fixed idea. He has always right, other people were wrong, he used to think that. So another Jidima, he always think himself as a very absolute person who invented miraculous cement, who was a proud in nature person. And then we have another story that is In Another Country by Ernest Hemingway. This is also short story. This story is about the wounded soldiers who were out from their country in another country. Especially there is a narrator, that is Nick Adams, and 3 wounded Italian officers. They had planned to be a lawyer, painter, and soldier before the war, respectively. There is a major as well. He married a young girl after he retired. She died of pneumonia. In Another Country shows that is in one picture of wounded soldiers. When soldiers were in the battlefield, they were hardly brave, but when they got wounded, then no one took care of it, and even the public and other people as well. So this history shows the history of Major as well, who missed his wife when he got married at the old age, but he missed her due to she died of pneumonia there. So this study shows the pitiful condition of the wounded soldiers in the war. We see that. And there are some questions here. What does the history tell us about how a man should behave? This one Nobel Prize winner, Ernest Hemingway, has written this story. So this story shows a bitter experience of the wounded soldiers. We see in the story. Then we have next question. Why does the major say that the narrator must not marry? So that is the next question. He says that we should not get married because if we marry, then we will lose our wife. Then lots of trouble and problems within our life. His response is that. Then after this, we have short story, that is The Valiant Woman. The Valiant Woman, that is the study by James J. F. Powers, James Harl Powers, who was educated at the Western University of Chicago. Especially there are The Valiant Woman, especially is the history about Catholic Church, wrong activities done by the father of the church, it shows there. Especially there are some characters, Father Firmian, Father Nolte, Mrs. Stoner, or housekeeper, Father Doolin, Fish Frawley, and Bishop. Especially the story begins with Father Firmian's, Father Firmian's 59th birthday. All the fathers, they gather there and they talk very different things about the woman. And some of the fathers, they get right of their woman. And some of the fathers, they went to their cinema and they talk about very unnecessary things. It's especially this history shows private life of the Catholic Church priest. There is one character, Mrs. Stoner, housekeeper. She is a really bold character who stays with Father Firmian, and she looks very brave and a very valiant woman we see in the story. So she is living with Father Firmian for long years, and she likes him as well, but she could not express her feelings, and Father Firmian also could not express his feeling to her. So in this way, this story shows the private life of Catholic Church, Catholic priest church, and their activities in their life. This story shows, short story shows that. So there is a especially this prison study shows the Roman Catholic priest in a difficult situation regarding their relation with different persons. Here, Father Firmian, difficult situation with his relation with the housekeeper, and Mrs. Stoner, who has completely dominated him and away taken his place. So that is the idea here. Especially, there are some questions here. Is the history disrespectful to the Catholic Church and the priesthood? Give reason. The history of The Valiant Woman is an interesting story written by J.F. Powers. This history is about relation between man and woman in the context of Roman Catholic. It presents the private life of Roman Catholic priest in off-duty moment and deals with the moral and practical difficulties faced by them. It is shows disrespectful to the Catholic Church and the priesthood. It shows there. That is the history. Then we have next question. How would you like to treat the history in terms of exposition, complications, and denouement? We would like to treat the history in terms of exposition, complication, and denouement. Father Nolte in the beginning has invited his 59th birthday party of Father Firmian. So this history begins from there. Then we have next question. Comment on the few selected example of comic elements in the history. This history is titled with a lot of comic elements there by talking of their fathers. So this history shows this, The Valiant Woman. Then we have another short story, that is Enemies by Anton Chekhov. One Russian writer. Especially in the history, there are some characters. One Kirillov, one district doctor. His 6-year son, he just died of diphtheria. And Kirillov's wife, Abogin's Papchinsky dear. Abogin's who come to visit to doctor house. He wants to invite the doctor to his house because his wife was not feeling well. So when the doctor's son was died at the time, Abogin came there. Later on, doctor knew that, and Abogin's knew that his wife, Abogin's wife, ran away with Papchinsky. So in this study shows when people are in trouble, when people are in tension, they become self-centered, they become quite generous, and they could not help others. They become selfish nature and self-centered is shows in the story. So one doctor lost his son, and at the time one visitor came to his house asking to go into his house to look after for the treatment of his wife. Later on, he knew that his wife ran away with one person. So in this story shows very quite unusual ending. So why does Dr. Kirillov use a grip to assert his dignity, and to what effect? That is the question. This shows Evergreens, natural evergreens, that is doctor's problem and evergreens problem is shown here. Especially that is sorrowful heart to see evergreens when he was become very much sad. The next one is Chekhov says that unhappy man or selfish, how does it apply to it? Dr. Kirilov and Evergreen. You can go through these lines there. Chekhov says that unhappy men and selfish, bad and less able to understand each other than the fools. Unhappy men are usually trapped in unwanted and difficult problems. Mental and physical tortures are part of their life. That is the idea the writer wants to convey through this study. Then next one is, what is the moral of the story? That is, the writer says that unhappy men are selfish. That is essential part of the story, it shows. Then we have short story, that is Dichox. Dichox, that is Guy de Maupassant, who was a famous French novelist and a short story writer. So in the story, there are some characters. One is Baron Modrian, one aristocratic old bachelor is fed up with his monotonous life. Dichox, a secret son with Baron, and Josephine, Dichox's wife, and Mr. Morlin. He discusses himself as a Mr. Morlin Baron. So this story shows one that is modern men's nature. Modern men only crap for comfort, money, and other different things. In the history, we see that is the people who have full of luxurious life, and the people who are living in the town and village. There is a comparison. The people who live in modern civilization, they are separated from the true self nature shown in the story. One character, Baron, when he was a young age, he fell in love with one lady. The lady was pregnant and she gave the birth of one child. The child was taken to Marseilles in the Marseilles, and it was very far from Baron Modrin. So Baron Modrin, when he became old and he lost his gambling, so he wanted to go there and he wanted to see son Dichox. And the son had already got married and he had grandchildren as well. So when Baron went there, he did not get his introduction to his son, and he did not even talk to his grandchildren, because he did not like the odor of garlic. So when he smelled the odor of garlic, he really got irritated from there, and without any introduction, he came back to his town. So in this way, this story shows the ruler and that is uncultured environment of the matter, and the Baron Modrin, he thought about this. Some questions are there. What is the main theme of this story? The main theme of the story, that is the long separateness of father from the son, which haunts the mind of the father, is the main theme of the story. This is a story about a generation gap. Baron Modrin is running his life in his own way. He is not satisfied and runs away. He wants to get back, but in reality, it is not possible. He regrets for not getting what he wants. Our desire for things which we have not seen in its negative result that come later, one in reality is the another theme of the story. We can get that. There is another study. Does the study imply that modern civilization has alienated man from his true or nature? Definitely yes. That is the answer there. Then we have next question. Would the history be different from Baron Modrian, where a landlord looking after his farm in a village? Yes, that is also the question. Then we have another essay, that is The Day of the Dead. This is an interesting story. This essay talks about one Mexican fiestas, Mexican festivals. This essay was written by Octavio Paz, one Mexican writer. So in the essay, the writer discuss about how joyously and how happily people celebrated this festival. When it comes in a particular day, they celebrate very differently, very enthusiastically, which is different from North American and Europeans. All over the year, they wait for the day in which day they celebrate differently, by with the colors as we dancing, singing, and running in the street and dancing in the group as well. They really have a very enthusiastic poll. Even the day will be a dead one. So in this, the writer discuss about one great festival celebrated in Mexico community. So in this essay, that is The Day of the Dead, there is a question. There are some questions. What factor contribute to popularity of fiestas in Mexico, especially in relation to Mexican national character? That is, the writer has discussed there. Then the next question, in what ways the people experience of time different during the fiestas, qualitatively different from their experience during the rest of the year? So the writer has discussed that idea there. And next question, what are the Mexican attitude towards the celebration of life and death? The Mexican people of Fiestas, they have nothing others to celebrate like North Americans and Europeans. So they have discussed about this, you can see in the essay. Then we have next essay, the time factor. So this time factor is also interesting essay by Gloria Estefan, one feminist writer. The time factor is an interesting essay written by Gloria Estefan. The prison essay is based on making plan for future passive. The statement says that our sense of time is partly a function of power, lack of it here. Feminist writer says that women are not given a chance to make a future plan. Only the white person, only the male, only the people who have high class, they are making plan for their future passive. So poor people, they plan for a day, for a week. For rich people and powerful people, they plan for a year, for a next generation to next generation. So here, women and blacks and powerless poor people, they are not able to plan for their future generation. Here, one female writer, she discussed about making plan about this. And there are some questions. How do you explain the difference between Trump class and caste here? A class is a social group who has the same social, political, and economic rank and position. The writer has discussed in this essay, and that is time factor. And next question is, how does Stephen differentiate the future planning, which is culturally masculine habit of planning, to the woman plan for future in the essay, the time factor? So it is there. That is our next question is, how do you interpret Stephen's thesis that your sense of time is partly a function of power or lack of it? So that is the idea there. Then we have next essay, that is, what is poverty? That is by Jo Godin Parker, one female writer. So in the essay, we see that the different definition of poverty, that is, this is a personal essay as well, how poverty capture the people's life and how miserable condition people have to pass when they involve in poverty. It shows miserable experience of the writer being faced poverty in her life. So in the essay, what is poverty, by Jo Godin Parker, we see that various aspect of poverty in the essay the writer has discussed there. And there are some questions. Is there such a thing as small as poverty? If so, what is that? So there are different things the writer has been discussed, different aspect of poverty she has described. And next question is, what is the Parker's purpose in defining poverty as she does? The purpose of defining poverty is to prevent realistic picture of poverty. She presents the actual account of poverty. She also wants to show how much humiliation, immoral, and simple is being poor. It shows there. And next question is, why did Parker quit her job? Why did Parker not have the operation that was recommended for a year? She quit her job because there was nobody to care of her children when she was at work. Her mother was not a reliable person. She would not look after them properly. Moreover, her wage was not high enough to admit her children in a nursery school and support for them. Parker did not have the operation that was recommended to her because it will cost too much too money and a long time to see. And that is her problem she discussed there. Then we have another very suspense and mysterious story, that is 100 Gratzos. So 100 Gratzos, that is by Franz Kafka, was born in Prague, Czechoslovakia. Especially there are some character, 100 Gratzos, a hunter who fell from precipice in the Black Forest in Germany while he was hunting a camel deer. So there is a burgomaster Riva, one gentleman, Salvatore. So the boatman and Julia, the boatman's wife. So this history shows the plight of a woman suffering is the direct consequence of his sinfulness. According to the reading, that is 100 Gratzos, he was killed there. And later on, he's due to his sinfulness, nature, death ship missed the way, death ship could not reach its destination. He wanted to go heaven, but his death ship could not get its destination. So in the history, we see that very suspense and interesting one. There are some questions. What is the most terrible thing about the history of the 100 Gratzos? The loneliness and the sorrow of dead person in the most terrible thing in the history. The dead body is alone and no one is ready to help, even at his last moment. The thought of the help has become a kind of illness. The illness has to be corrected by taking to the bed and show him the right path to the heaven or hell. Heaven to the hell there. So that is such kind of loneliness and being that is a passive to help is really terrible. Then another question, discuss the undergrasses as a bizarre, strange story, Omanax existence. Definitely, it is really strange story. If you go through the story there, then we have another short story by D. Grasso, Hotel of Odisha by Isaac Babel. This study also shows the one Sicilian Trajan, and that is one about the Hotel of Odisha. There are some characters, the speaker, 14 years old, who was a ticket seller, Nick Swartz, his boss, and Madame Swartz, his wife, D. Grasso, Sicilian Trajan, who performed Sicilian folk drama, or this farmer, his daughter, Sekhor, Giovanni, who came from the city. Especially, this is an interesting story written by Isaac Babel. Here it is the speaker is the narrator, who worked as a ticket seller. Nick Swartz, his drama was going very was not going very well, so he was bankrupted. So later on he called Sicilian Trajan, D. Grasso came there, and with the help of D. Grasso he performed well. He performed different types of plays in the stage, and later on he really became famous, and every people attracted him there. So ultimately Sicilian drama became popular there again. So the problem is there, Nick Swartz, he did not return back the watch of the writer, that is speaker, and his speaker talked to it to his boss wife, and later on due to the Madam Swartz, the speaker, he got the watch back there. So in this way, very interesting story. There are some questions, how was the young narrator able to retrieve his watch? And there he asked to the Madam Swartz, and later on he was able to got that watch, and the boy became very much happy, which in the story. And then after we have next short story, that is The Big Fish. The Big Fish, that is by Chen Joshi, one she was born in Taiwan. This story shows some characters are there, Kwai Sifu, one husband, Mama Kwai, wife, Chang Sao, neighbor, and the cadreman or middle-aged man. And this story shows Chen Joshi, this story simply expresses the plight of an old man who wishes to buy a fish to make a soup for his sick wife. But that is Kwai Sifu, he could not buy the fish because the cadreman of the market, he told him that that it is for only seeing for the foreign visitors. He could not be able to take that fish to his house. So in this way, this history shows characters and plots, the plots very interestingly. We see in the story, that is The Big Fish. One man wants to buy a fish soup for his wife, but he could not get that. We see in the story. Then after we have next essay, one article, or day in the life of salaryman. This was by John Borges. This article is about Japanese white collar worker, especially what sort of working industry, especially in Japan. Every laborers, every workers, they are industrial barrier. The life of worker depend upon the company of the life of the company depends upon the life of the workers in Japan. This shows one person who from the morning to evening, from dawn to dusk, how he perform his tasks. It is shown in this article by John Borges, A Day in the Life of Salaryman, who works up all in the morning, then he prepares some ideas, and then he departs to his office by the train, and he goes there and he attends many meetings there, and in the evening as well he goes somewhere to make the guest and make the customer very happy there. And at late night he returns back to his house. On that time the children have already slept. So in this way, this history shows a day in the life of a salaryman, also shows what sort of people, what sort of workers are there in Japan, how devoted they are there towards their company. It is shown there. There are some questions. What is the attitude towards work in Japan? Does the name salaryman imply? How does the fact Borges implied data for his article over 3 years? It shows there. That is all about salaryman's there. Then we have next question. What is salaryman's job, and what do you think Borges chose? Borges, choose these types of character there. In the article we see that that is the average white collar worker we see in this. Then next question, how does salaryman decision to stay in the same company for all his working life? It shows this. Then we have next one is the penalty of death. The penalty of death is about why is it good or not to do penalty for death when someone commits murder deliberately or unknowingly. It shows about this. This is an interesting essay by H.L. Mencken. This is his advocates in favor of death penalty. Mencken thinks that capital punishment is a very beneficial component of an justice system. Mencken thinks that the death penalty should be given to those who take the life of other people, challenging all civilized order. He presents the three reasons for his support, that is capital punishment. The prison means are mentioned are deterrence and catharsis as well here. Mencken attacks the adolescent idea that a woman's job is unpleasant. He claims that there are different many jobs which are unpleasant, like jobs of soldier. So he is in favor of that is death penalty here. So he gives different terms here, catharsis. So that is the release of the mind, that is as a use revenge there. We see in this essay. Then there are some questions. Identify Mencken's three reasons for support the capital punishment. He says three reasons here, especially he says the adolescent, that is abolitionist idea that hangman's job is unpleasant. One reason is that. Next one is capital punishment saves lives. It saves lives because it stops those murder who even murdering again. It also deter potential murderers from ever committing the crime. And the last reason is Mencken gives it the strongest of all. He claims that the main idea of the death punishment is to catharsis. His idea is given in such a way there. Then we have the last lesson, that is Zeroing in Science Fiction by Greg Goskarian. This science fiction talks about the different types of science fiction and non-science fiction. He defines science fiction as a branch of literature that imaginatively speculates human life in the scientific and technological world. Due to the proper understanding of this definition, even fantasy, magical and mystical fiction are put under the category here. The writer has discussed in this essay about science fiction and non-science fiction, that is a hard science fiction and soft science fiction. He has given different example of Frankenstein and Dracula as a soft science fiction and hard science fiction here. So this is all about the science fiction. Greg Goskarian, he presented his idea very dramatically, realistically he presented his idea in the essay. There is a question, how does Goskarian draws distinction between hard science fiction and soft science fiction? In this essay, in this essay, Zeroing in Science Fiction, Greg Goskarian defines science fiction as a branch of literature that imaginatively speculates the human life in scientific or technological world. Science fiction differs from other kinds of fiction in the sense that science fiction always gives a scientific logic for any imagination. It does not present any even without scientific rationale. In other kinds of fiction, the consequences are caused by magic or supernatural power. Science fiction always predicts possibility, while other kinds of fiction may present any event that is impossible. Goskarian thinks that Frankenstein is a science fiction, while Dracula is a fantasy fiction there. So Goskarian also distinguishes between hard science fiction and soft science fiction. Hard science fiction takes help of known principle and inventions to fill their stories with scientific jargons. The heroes are usually scientists or engineers. The readers with good knowledge of science can only enjoy these types of fiction. That is, on the other hand, soft science fiction takes the help of sociology, anthropology, psychology, philosophy, and other branches of knowledge to show the moral and social result of scientific advancement. It deals how the scientific development will influence morality, evolution, and environment. Clockwork Orange by Anthony Burgess is soft science fiction. Frankenstein by Mary Shelley, that is hard science fiction. Student, I hope you got the concept. We discuss all lessons belongs to Encounter book. From lesson 1 to 16, we discuss about different studies and essay here. I hope you got the concept. If you have any confusion, don't forget to comment there. Finally, subscribe my channel, Versatile Learning Network. If you have any confusion, you can put the question there. I will satisfy with the answer there. Hope to meet you in our next video, in our next class. Take care. Goodbye.